好，那么各位弟兄姐妹们，今天有我要跟大家来思想的这个课题呢，就是尊荣我们的神第二讲。
So today's message will be topic is honoring our God, part two.
好，那么呢，经文呢是在路加福音第10章25到28节。
So scripture is taken from the book the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verse 25 to 28.
啊，那么啊，这段经文跟上个星期 Brother Ham 的讲到的经文很相似哈，只是不同的书卷而已。
So the scripture we are looking into this morning is quite similar to what Brother Ham has shared last week.
只不过我要从这个尊荣我们的神这个角度，一起的跟大家来思考这个的经文。
Just that we are looking into this scripture from the perspective of honoring our God.
好，我先读华语，你读英文哈。有一个律法师起来试探耶稣，说：“夫子，我该做什么才可以承受永生？”耶稣对他说：“律法上写的是什么？里面的是怎么样呢？”他回答说：“你要尽心、尽性、尽力、尽意爱主你的神，又要爱邻舍如同自己。”耶稣说：“你回答的是，你这样行就必得永生。”
Luke chapter 10, verse 25 to 28. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is it written in the law? He replied. How do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this and you will live.
好，那么今天呢，就透过耶稣跟法利赛人的对话，我们看几个重点。
So today we will be looking into this conversation between Jesus and the Pharisee and learn a few lessons.
那这次圣经给我们看到有一个很厉害的这个律法师哦，他来试探耶稣，他问他说：“我应该怎么样做才能够得到永生？”
So in this passage, we can see that an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. And he asked, "What must I do to inherit eternal life?"
耶稣没有正面的回答他，反而问回他说：“你觉得呢？”
So Jesus did not give him like a direct answer, but Jesus asked him instead, "What do you think?"
他的回答呢，是一个犹太人非常非常标准的经文的答案就是你要尽心、尽性、尽力、尽力尽意爱主你的神，又要爱邻舍如同爱自己。
So the answer that this Pharisee gave is like the model answer from the scripture, which is love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself.
所以在这一段经文里面呢，其实有三个重点。
So in this passage, we can see that there are three main points.
好，首先呢，这个耶稣提到你要经文提到你要尽心尽意尽力的爱我们的神，意思就是我们要先好好的来尊荣我们的神。
So firstly, the scripture said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and all your mind, which means to honor God first.
哦，尊荣神的意思就是全心的爱神，包括你的时间、你的才干、你的恩赐、你的奉献，还有你的生命。
So to honor God is to love God wholeheartedly, which includes your time, your talents, your gifts, your offering, including your life.
OK，好，那么爱好好的尊荣神之后呢，你才能够去爱你的邻舍。
So only after loving and honoring God, then you can love your neighbors.
我们千万不要把这段经文分成两个部分哦，一个是爱神，一个是爱人。
So let us not separate this scripture into two parts, which is first honoring God, then love your neighbors.
我们也不要以为说这个命令呢是你可以选 A 或者 B 你可以选择尊重爱神如果呢你也可以选择去爱人所以呢选两个里面选一个就好了。
So this command is also not a choice between either you should love God or you should love your neighbor.
OK， 但是这段经文呢，其实是两个是在一起的哈，先爱神，然后呢再爱人。
So in fact, this scripture is seen as a whole, which is first to love God and to honor God first, then to love your neighbors.
因为如果你没有先爱神的话呢，你就很难按照神的心意去爱人。
Because if we don't first love God, it is very difficult to love our neighbors.
Okay, 所以因此呢，耶稣说，当你坐在最小的一个人身上的时候呢，你就是坐在我的身上。
Therefore, Jesus also said, truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me.
爱邻舍呢，就是坐在一个最不起眼的人身上。
So to love your neighbors is to serve the least of the people.
坐在别人看不起或者是别人抛弃人的身上，这就是最不起眼的意思。
So to serve those who are lowly and those who are neglected, which means to serve those which are least in the community.
而当我们学习这样去做的时候呢，我们就是在尊荣神，神的尊荣也在你的身上。
And when we do so, we are honoring God, and in return, God will also honor you.
好，那么呢，接下来呢，其实尊荣神啊，就是爱自己。
So next, let us look. Honoring God is also loving yourself.
爱自己的意思呢，就是要对自己好啊。
So what does it mean by loving yourself? It means to do good to yourself.
我们常常看到这个的广告哈，就说啊，女人你要学习爱自己，对不对？
So we always see in the commercials or the sponsored posts that you say that, oh, ladies, you need to learn how to love yourself.
好，但是我们没有看到有广告这样跟男生说，男人你要学习爱自己啊。
But we seldom see the commercials targeting the male group saying that, oh, guys, you should also love yourself.
哦，那是不是意思就是哈，男生你不用教，他都懂得怎么样爱自己了
？Does it mean that men doesn't need to learn how to love themselves also？
那这个世界给我们很多的教我们很多的东西，教我们怎样去爱自己。
So the world actually teaches us a lot of methods and ways how to love ourselves。
买好的营养来吃啊。
So, purchase many kinds of supplements.
买好的护肤品啊。
Buy a lot of good skincare.
去吃一些好吃的东西啊。
Go for a lot of good food.
哎，这些都好，但是请问它是否有永恒的价值呢？
So all these mentioned just now are actually good, but do they have eternal value?
圣经也教导我们去爱自己。
So in the Bible also teaches us to love ourselves.
但是这个爱自己呢，就是去好好善待你的灵魂。
But what the Bible teaches us is to take good care of your spirit.
让你的灵魂健康，能够一直到你见主面的那一天。
To take good care of our spirit and our soul so that we will have a healthy spirit until we meet God.
好。如果不好好敬拜，不好好祷告，不好好给神时间，不好好学习怎么去饶恕人，不好好学习去爱灵舍，其实这一些都不算是爱自己。
Without worship, without prayer, or without spending time with God, without forgiveness, or without loving our neighbors, we cannot truly love ourselves.
因为呢，就算你拥有这些很好的护肤品啊，你吃好吃的，你有很健康的身体啊，但是你的灵魂始终充满了破碎、苦毒、伤害、软弱，这样的话呢，反而是没有帮助的。
So because if we only have all the good supplements and all the good skincare and all the good food, without all these mentioned just now, our spirit will be filled with bitterness and brokenness and hurt. It is not possible to love ourselves.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，爱自己的话呢，你就更应该好好的跟主耶稣基督建立美好的关系。
So to truly love yourself is to have a good relationship with God.
好，所以呢，第一个就是好好尊荣神，然后呢，尊荣神才能够爱邻舍。接下来呢，尊荣神就是爱自己。
So at this point, we can see that first, we should honor God, then love your neighbors. And by honoring God, we are also loving ourselves.
好，那么第二点，我们来看看尊荣的对象。
So secondly, we want to look at whom do you honor?
好，那在诗篇第91篇14到16节这样说，神说，因为他专心爱我，我就搭救他。我因为他知道我的名，我要把他安置在高处。他若求告我，我就应允他。他在急难中，我要与他同在，我要搭救他，使他尊贵或者尊荣的意思。
So in Psalms 91, verse 14 to 16 says, "Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation."
哎呀 ，OK， 我的经文那边少打了一节啊，就是呢，我要使他主享长寿，将我的救恩赐给他。那圣经给我们看到尊荣神的对象，当然肯定第一个就是尊荣我们的神。
So from the scripture, the first subject that we should honor is of course honoring God.
OK， 因为而当我们在尊荣神的时候，神说什么呢？他就搭救我们，把我们放在高处。应允我们，与我们同在，使我们尊荣。
Because in this scripture we can say that when we honor him, God will deliver us and God will be with us when we are in trouble.
Okay, 好，因此呢，这里给我们看到说，尊荣神呢是人的本分。
So we can see that it is our duty to honor God.
还有呢，尊荣神的人呢，必被神来尊荣。
And to those who honor God, God will also honor.
还有第三呢，就是尊荣神的人呢，必受到人的尊荣。
And to those who honor God, men will honor.
我们看到我们的历史当中有很多很伟大的这些的人哈，包括宋尚节牧师。包括戴德森，包括约翰卫斯理，包括马丁路德等等这些伟人，他们尊荣神，因此呢，他们也被人来尊荣。
So from history we can see that there are many famous people who are very honorable because they first honor God. For example, Pastor John Song, and then Hudson Taylor, John Wesley and Martin Luther.
所以因此呢，让我们记得尊荣神是人的本分。
Therefore, let us remember that it is our duty to honor God.
还有尊荣神的人呢，必被神尊荣。
And to those who honor God, God will also honor.
然后呢，尊荣神的人呢，必受别人的尊荣。
And to those who honor God, men will honor.
好，第二点我们来看尊荣神尊荣神的对象还有什么呢？第二就是尊荣神所设立的权柄和领袖。
So secondly, whom do you honor? The second subject is, honor the elders and authorities which are established by God.
尊荣你的领袖呢，其实是来自神的命令来的。
So to honor the leaders actually is a command from God.
不管对方的年龄多大多小，能力多强多弱。我们都应该去尊荣他们。
Regardless of that person's age or power, we are commanded and we should honor them.
而当我们尊荣领袖的时候呢，我们也会得到尊荣。
And when we honor our leaders, we in return will be honored.
圣经给我们看到几个的非常棒的榜样哦。
So we can see many examples in the Bible.
我们看到。撒母耳他尊荣以利。
Firstly, we see we can see that how Samuel honored Eli.
那以利不是一个完全的士师哈，而且呢，他的孩子啊，非常糟糕，不敬畏神，不尊荣神。
So Eli wasn't a perfect judge, and furthermore, his children also do not respect and honor God.
虽然以利是一个很差劲的领袖，但是撒母耳依然尊荣以利。
We can see that how Samuel honored Eli, although Eli wasn't a perfect judge.
还有呢，第二，我们看到大卫他尊荣扫罗王。
So the second example, we can see how David honored King Saul.
扫罗是一个怎么样的王？相信我们大家都知道哦。
So I believe all of us knows, at the end, how did King Saul behave?
扫罗他充满了很多苦读，还有呢，心中都是那种的妒忌啊。
So King Saul at the point was filled with bitterness and jealousy.
而且呢，他不敬畏神，加上处处呢，他想要除掉大卫。
On top of that, he did not honor God and wanted to kill David.
大卫有好几次机会能够干掉扫罗，但是他没有这样做，反而他尊荣神所设立的君王，因为呢，扫罗他是神的高立，神所高立的。
So when David had multiple chances where he could kill King Saul, he did not. On the other hand, he preserved Saul's life because David honored God. As King Saul was the king that is established by God.
还有呢，提摩太他尊荣保罗。
Next, we can see how Timothy honored Paul.
那提摩太是保罗的属灵孩子，他听从保罗话，他谦卑学习。
We can see that Timothy was Paul's spiritual son, child. Timothy listened and obeyed to Paul, humbled himself, and learned from Paul.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，虽然我们看到领袖他们会做错事情，甚至常常做错决定，甚至在很多地方他们都不完全。
Dear brothers and sisters, we can see that many leaders might do wrong things or make the wrong decision and imperfect in many ways.
但是神依然要我们学习去尊荣这些的领袖。
But despite being imperfect, God still wants us to honor our leaders.
我相信这就是神要我们所学习的功课。
So I believe that this is a lesson from God.
因为有一天，当我们成为领袖的时候呢，我们需要带领身边的人。那时候呢，我们就要懂得怎么样去成为好的榜样，并且去建立一个尊荣的文化。
So this is also to prepare us, when we ourselves are leaders one day in the future. We need to guide the people around us so that we will know how to be a good role model and how to build a culture which learns and respects and honors one another.
那在如果有工作的弟兄姐妹们，你肯定有这样的体验哦。
So for those who are in the working sector, you will experience, this.
好，我们不会常常遇到很好的上司或者老板。
So many a times we wouldn't meet with good leaders or good bosses.
请问，当我们遇到老板不好的时候呢，是否我们就不用再去尊荣他了？
But do you disrespect your boss just because they are difficult?
他叫你做事情的时候呢，你反驳他，拒绝去做，不要去做。
So do you go against them or him or reject his orders?
那我这里说的不是那些违背我们信仰，还有去害人或者是犯法的事情啊。
So here we are not talking about doing the illegal things or things that are against the Bible's teaching.
我们在工作上，我们选择去尊荣，去顺服我们的上司。
So in our workplace, if we can honor and respect and follow the instructions of our bosses.
同样的，在我们的家庭、我们的教会、我们的生活当中，我们是否也愿意去尊荣我们的领袖和他们去配搭呢？
So in the same manner, are we willing to honor the leaders at home or in church?
第三个尊荣的对象就是尊荣父母和长辈。
Thirdly, we should honor our parents and elders.
那这是我们需要去学习的东西。
So, this is an important lesson.
我们的父母亲是神给我们在地上的代表来的。
So, parents are given to us by God as a representative.
意思就是呢，父母亲是代表神来教养儿女，因为 儿女是神所赐的产业。
So parents are actually given by God to represent God, to teach us and to guide us.
基督教比任何宗教都更加看重孝敬父母，尊荣长辈。
The Christian faith has emphasizes honoring parents and elders more than any other religion.
因为当我们在孝敬父母亲的时候呢，我们在尊荣长辈的时候，其实我们就是在尊荣我们的神。
When we respect our parents and elders, we are actually honoring God.
出埃及记这样说，当孝敬父母，使你的日子在耶和华你神所赐你的地上得以长久。
As it is stated in Exodus, says, honor your father and your mother, so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，让我们记住这一句话。
So, dear brothers and sisters, let us remember this.
父母亲给儿女最大的礼物呢，是榜样。
So, the greatest gift from a parent is to be a role model.
而儿女呢，送给父母亲最大的礼物呢，是什么呢？是尊荣，或者是荣耀这个字 ，doxa。
And the greatest gift from a child to their parents is honor and respect.
儿女们，尊荣你的父母亲，其实就是把荣耀给你的父母亲。
Dear children, to honor your parents is actually to give glory to your parents.
而父母亲，如果你要把最好的礼物给你的儿女的话呢，那就是要做好一个好的榜样。
So parents, if you want to give the best to your children, be a role model to them.
你愿意吗？
Are you willing?
那么最后呢，第三，我们来看一看尊荣的危机。
Lastly, let us look at what is the crisis of honor?
是什么东西导致呢？我们不能够去尊荣。
So what affects us and what causes us, to not be able to honor one another?
好，首先第一个呢，我们来看的就是熟悉感。
So first, let's speak about familiarity.
耶稣他在他家乡传道的时候呢，大家当时都认识他的。
So when Jesus was first preaching in his hometown, everyone 认识，
大家认识耶稣的。
Everyone recognizes him.
在路加福音第四章哈，耶稣在会堂讲道的时候呢，圣经说什么？圣经说众人都称赞他，并且稀奇他口中所出的恩言，又说：“哎，这不是约瑟的孩子吗？”
So in Luke chapter 4, we can see that when Jesus was teaching in the synagogue, Verse 22, it says, all spoke well of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his lips. And they asked, isn't this Joseph's son?
意思就是说大家很熟悉他的家庭，对他的爸爸很认识，而且当耶稣小时候出生的时候，做小孩子的时候呢，大家都看着他长大的意思。
So, in this passage, we can see that the people at Jesus' hometown actually recognizes him and knows him very well. They know his father, which is Joseph, and then they actually know him and seen him grow up since young.
所以大家对摩西的大家对耶稣的家庭非常熟悉，而且呢，甚至对耶稣这个人也非常熟悉。
So the people were very familiar with Jesus and his family.
而很多时候就是当你越熟悉的时候呢，你越难接受。
So when you are so familiar with this person, it's very difficult to accept them.
在路加福音第四章二十二节这样说，众人当耶稣说福音要传给外邦人的时候呢，众人生气了，圣经这样说，会堂里听见这话的人都怒气满胸，就起来轰他出城，他们的城造在山上，他们带他到山崖，要把他推下去。
So we can also see that when the locals heard that the gospel will be also preached to the Gentiles, all the people in the synagogue were furious, and when they heard this, they got up, drove him out of the town, and took him to the brow of the hill on which the town was built, in order to throw him down the cliff.
那很多时候呢，熟悉感呢，会让我们忘记要尊荣神所差派在我们身边的这些人。
So very often, familiarity will make us forget how to honor the people God has put in our lives.
你看到他的时候，你就会，哎呀，这个就是我从小看到他长大的那个人啊。
So when you see them, you will say, oh, I know this person and I've known them since young.
他所做过的全部的坏事我都知道啊。
So I know all of his wrongdoings.
那这个是他的第一个女朋友，这是第二个女朋友啊。
I know this is his first girlfriend and then this is his second girlfriend.
那因为太熟悉了，所以呢，往往我们会忘记甚至忽略了要去尊荣那些我们很熟悉的人。
So because we know them too well, because we are too familiar with them, we forget how to respect and honor them.
但是呢，往往他们就是神所差派给我们的人。
So, but many a times, these are the people that God has put into our lives.
比如说某某人是你的小组组长啊，是你的团契领袖啊，是教会的执事等等啊。因为熟到出字了，你知道吗？所以往往很多时候在言语啊、行为上，甚至一些的回应上呢，我们不太对了。
So for example, they may be your cell group leader, the president of your fellowship, or the leader of a certain ministry. That because you have known them so well, that you have spent so much time with them, you are so familiar with them, and then we might get overboard with our actions and our speech.
有时候呢，我们就会说出一些不太适合的言语或者是行为，就是因为我们太熟悉了。
Sometimes our actions and our speech may be inappropriate because we know them too well.
那我并不是说我们应该保持距离哦，而是当我们越熟悉的时候呢，我们越不可以忘记对方是神放在我们身边，要来带领我们，要来带领教会。来发展他的工作，甚至呢是要我们去学习成长的器皿。
So here I don't mean to say that we should keep our distance with one another, but also in our familiarity, when we are so familiar and so close to one another, we still have to remember that these people are God-given leaders in the family or in the church.
其实话说回来，我们最熟悉的有时候就是我们的家人。反而很多时候呢，要尊荣我们的家人、家庭的成员呢，反而是一件不容易的事情，对不对呢
？So speaking of which, the most familiar people to us is our family members. Therefore, sometimes it's very difficult to respect or to honor our family members.
所以第一个尊荣的危机呢，会破坏尊荣的第一个就是熟悉感。
So the first crisis of honor, which makes honoring so difficult, is first familiarity.
第二就是优越感。
So secondly, is superiority.
保罗在腓立比书这样说：你们要意念相同，爱心相同，有一样的心思，有一样的意念，使我们的喜乐可以满足。凡事不可结党，不可贪图虚浮的荣耀，只要什么呢？存心谦卑。
So Paul said in Philippians chapter 2, verse 2 to 3, Then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and purpose. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider others better than yourselves.
其实啊，人呢，始终都是看自己比别人强的。
So we always think that we are better than others.
凭什么我要我这个人去听他呢？
We always think, why do I have to listen to others?
从孩子开始，进入到少年，去到青年、成年，甚至退休，我们常常都会有这种的优越感，使到我们总是觉得自己比别人强。
So since when we are a young child into teenagers or adults or up to old age, many of us think thinks that we are superior than others, leading us to think ourselves higher than others.
当我们看别人比自己强的时候呢，意味着我们觉得自己比他人优越。
So, in occasions where we feel that we are stronger than others, this also indicates that we have the superior feeling.
而优越感呢，它会使到我们没有办法去尊荣其他人。
So this feeling of superiority will hinder us from respecting and honoring others.
特别是那些比我们差，或者是我们看他们比我们差的那些人。
Especially to the people who we think and who we deem less than us.
在罗马书这样告诉我们，我凭所赐给我的恩对你们个人说，不要看自己过于当看的，要照着神所分给个人的信心的大或小，看得合乎中道。
In Romans chapter 12, verse 3, For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the measure of faith God has given you.
我很喜欢这句话哈，这句话这样说，不要小看自己，但是你要少看自己。
So there's this saying, that goes, do not think less of yourself, but think of yourself less.
有时候呢，我们会过于轻视自己，但是呢，有时候呢，我们也会过于高估自己啊。
Sometimes we belittle ourselves, but sometimes we also think very highly of ourselves.
因此呢，我们需要求神给我们智慧，怎么样来看我们自己。
So let us pray for wisdom from God to look at ourselves.
小看自己的意思哦，就是你什么东西都收起来哦。
To belittle yourself, it means like to think yourself as less worthy.
你看那个小那个华文的字哦，那个下面都勾起来，都收起来，然后不愿意走出去的。那不要小看的自己的意思呢，就是你不要太过自卑，而是你要积极把自己献给神，让他使用我们。
Let us not belittle ourselves or think.ourselves as less worthy because God still uses each and every one of us.
那么要少看自己又是什么意思呢？
But we should think of ourselves less.
少看自己的人呢，就是凡事看别人比自己强的人。
Which also means that we should think more highly of others than ourselves.
这样的话，我们才能够从别人的身上学习神要给我们学习的功课。
So when by doing so, we can learn many valuable and good lessons from others, which God's always used to teach us.
所以第二个会破坏尊荣的呢，就是优越感，让自己觉得自己比别人强。
So the second point that, which is, hinders us from honoring one another is superiority.
好，第三呢，就是忽视感。
So thirdly, neglect.
人呢总是往往先看得到你看得到的地方，但是你却很容易忽视那些看不到的地方。
So people often focus on the visible, but neglect those who are not so visible.
那看得到的部分就是你的脸啊，你的身体啊，你的外表啊，这些都是看得到的。
So, what does it mean by the visible? The things that you can see, which is, for example, the face, the body, the appearance.
那么看不到的部分呢，就是可能就是你的肝脏、你的内脏、你的血压、你的胆固醇、你的血糖等等。
So the things that are not so visible are like when you look at the person, the things that you cannot see. For example, their internal organs, their blood pressure, their cholesterol, their blood sugar.
今天如果有一个人没有了一条腿一只手，你还可以生存下去。
So if someone loses one hand or one leg, they still can survive.
但是如果你没有了心脏，没有了肠胃，你恐怕就会上天堂了。
So if you lose, on the other hand, if you lose your heart or like your gut, you might die.
我们常常关注的呢，都是看得到的部分。
So it is very easy to focus on the visible thing.
哦，特别是那些整天站在台上让大家看得到的啊，我们常常都会去关注那些看得到的。
Especially the people who are always working on stage.
当他们做得好的时候呢，啊，我们就很容易去尊荣他们，去听从他们。
And when we see them, it is very easy to give them respect and honor when they do a good job.
但是相反的，我们往往会忽略那些最小的弟兄或者是姐妹。
So on the contrary, we tend to neglect and forget the least of the brothers and sisters.
或者是那些默默在那边服侍，却是没有人看得到他们的。
For those who serve quietly, we always and often forget.
那些很忠心服侍、隐藏服侍、流着汗水、泪水在服侍的弟兄姐妹们，往往这些人呢，是支撑教会事工的重要人物。
All those who serve quietly and serve faithfully and do not show their service and work, these are always the people, the important ones who are supporting the church ministry.
那这不单单是讲到教会啊，我们的身边，我们所在的工作的地方等等，常常都会有这一些的人。
So these people, this group of people, the quiet ones and the not so visible ones, the ones who do their work in the backstage, we don't only find them in the church, we also find them in your workplace or in your community.
弟兄姐妹们，我们要学习去寻找这一群被忽视的人群，因为他们是最小的弟兄或者姐妹。
Dear brothers and sisters, let us learn to notice and to give respect to those who are working at the backstage and they are not so visible ones.
我们要学习去尊荣他们，鼓励他们，支持他们的服事。
We have to give them encouragement in their service.
因为呢，尊荣的第三个危机就是忽视感。当我们忽视对方的时候呢，就代表我们就会失去了尊荣他们。
Because neglect is the third crisis of honoring one another. When we start to neglect some certain group of people, we tend to forget how to respect and honor others.
好，所以呢，我讲完了哈，我总结一下今天的分享。今天我跟大家分享的题目就是尊荣我们的神。
So in conclusion, let me do a recap. So today we have shared on how to honor our God.
圣经告诉我们，你要尽心、尽性、尽力、尽意爱主你的神，又要爱邻舍如同自己。
The Bible teaches us to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your might, and love your neighbor as yourself.
所以因此在这里呢，我们被提醒，我们需要先好好的去尊荣神。
So therefore, we are reminded first to honor God.
尊荣神之后呢，我们才能够学习去尊荣我们身边的人，我们的邻舍。
So first honor God, then honor your neighbors.
还有呢，当我们在尊荣神的时候呢，其实我们就是在爱自己，尊荣自己。
And by honoring God, you are also loving yourself.
好，那么第二点呢，就是尊荣的对象。
Secondly, whom do you honor?
尊荣神是为优先的条件。
So firstly, firstly is to honor God.
然后呢，才是尊荣神所设立的权柄和领袖。
Then comes honoring the leaders and authorities established by God.
还有呢，接下来就是尊荣神给我们的父母亲，还有属灵的长辈们。
Next is to honor your parents and the elders.
好，那么第三呢，我们谈到这个尊荣的危机。
Thirdly, we spoke about what are the crises of honor.
那是什么因素使到我们很难去尊荣对方呢？
So, what are the certain factors that causes us to to be so difficult to honor one another?
首先呢，就是熟悉感。
Firstly, is familiarity.
就是因为跟对方太熟了，使到我们很难去尊重对方。
So familiarity makes it difficult for us to honor one another because we know them too well.
是否也因为这样呢？我们有意无意的也伤害了我们身边跟我们最熟悉的人呢？
Because of this, inadvertently, we hurt the people close to us.
我过去牧养几间教会都看到有这样的情况，就是呢，这两个人本来他们从小一起长大，他们的关系非常好的。
So, in many of the previous churches that pastor has attended, he met many of these situations that. This group of people or these two people grow up together and they are very close to each other.
哦，常常说啊，他们是哈、啊、一个裤子两个人一起穿的，关系好的不得了啊。
So they always say that, they are very closely knit together.
但是呢，不知道为什么后来呢，发生一些事情，结果这两个人彼此呢变成仇人了。
And because of some small situation, these two brothers or these two sisters, they are no longer friends. They became enemies.
啊，所以我们一去到一些教会的时候，他们就想，哎，巴斯特，我跟你讲哦，你要小心这两个人哦，哦，他们呢不可以在一起的，在一起就会爆炸那种的哦。
So then, there will be some people coming to tell Pastor that saying, Pastor, you have to be careful with these two people. They cannot sit together or they cannot be in the same group. If not.They will explode.
那为什么以前这么好，现在这么坏呢？
Why do they change from such a good relationship to such a severe conflict?
我猜想有没有可能就是因为这个熟悉感。
Is it because of this fact that they are too familiar to each other?
因为太熟悉之后呢，我们忘记了人跟人之间需要彼此尊重。
And because of this familiarity, we often forget to respect and to honor one another.
也因为这样呢，我们有意无意的伤害了这些跟我们最熟悉的人。
And because of this, we inadvertently hurt the people close to us.
他们可能就是你的家人，他可能是你的同工、你的团队，或者是跟你最亲密的人。
Be it your family, colleagues, team member, or any close ones.
你是否愿意学习去尊重他们，给他们有的应当有的这个看重
？Are you willing to honor and respect these people and see them as important？
第二，尊荣的危机告诉我们，第二个就是优越感。
The second crisis of honor is superiority。
你是否总是觉得自己懂得比别人还要多？
Do you always think more highly of yourself that you are more knowledgeable than others?
你是否陷入了那种自我优越的陷阱当中？
Have you fallen into the trap of feeling yourself as superior to others?
圣经提醒我们要看自己看得合乎中道。
The Bible reminded us to think of ourselves with sober judgment.
不要太高估自己，应当谦卑的多多向人学习。
Do not think highly of ourselves, but always be humble and learn from one another.
但是也不要太过轻看自己，忘记了其实神要用你的。
But at the same time, do not belittle ourselves and forgetting that God uses each and every one of us.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，在你的生命当中，是否有这个优越感，造成你很难？去尊荣身边的人呢
？So, dear brothers and sisters, do you feel superior than others? Do you feel superior to others, which hinders you from respecting and honoring others?
那最后一个就是忽视感。
Lastly, we look at neglect.
弟兄姐妹们，这是我们都要一起去逼自己去学习的东西。我们要寻找身边那些一直被我们长久被我们忽视的人。
This is a point where we have to learn together, which is how to notice the people who are always neglected.
我们要去关注他们，去鼓励他们，去谢谢他们，去尊荣他们。
We have to give them the same amount of attention, motivation, and support, and also to thank them and to honor them.
当你开始去寻找的时候，我告诉你，你会发现到，原来我们每一天都忽略了、忽视了身边很多很多人。
When we start doing this, this will make us realize that we have neglected many people in our lives.
你愿意从小事上开始做出不一样的改变吗？
Are you willing to make these little changes?
最后呢，也再次提醒大家，我们要一起成为一个 BBMC 的教会。
So lastly, we'd like to remind all of us once again that we should be a church of BBMC.
我们要信靠这位创造我们、拯救我们的上帝。
We have to believe in the God who created the heavens and the earth.
还有呢，我们要成为他人的祝福。
Let us be a blessing to one another.
第三呢，我们要用我们的言语、用文字来去激励、鼓励身边的人。
And thirdly, let us be a motivation to one another using our speech and actions.
好，最后呢，我们要记得要与人来连接。
Lastly, let us remember to connect with each other in our community.
对，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，让我们一起来学习尊荣神，还有呢，尊荣我们身边的人。
So, dear brothers and sisters, let us learn how to honor God and to honor the people around us.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
天父，我们在你面前，我们谢谢你，谢谢你今天早上向我们说话。我们祈求你的圣灵再次的带领我们，挑战我们，也让我们更新我们的心思和意念，以至于我们能够越来越像耶稣基督，帮助我们，使我们懂得怎么样尊荣神。透过尊荣你差派给我们的领袖，透过尊荣我们家中的长辈，我们身边的长辈，透过尊荣我们身边跟我们熟亲密的人，主，我们祈求你赐福我们，以至于我们的生命可以成为金灯台，荣耀主你的名字。我们谢谢你，我们尊荣你，我们赞美你。这么祷告祈求，奉靠耶稣基督的名，阿门。